Thank you to everyone who's been following this channel. I really appreciate reading your comments on YouTube and other platforms. Now, on with the show. This is AIBO. It means Artificial Intelligence Robot, and it means pal or partner in Japanese. AIBO is Sony's entertainment robot, first released in 1999. The model I have here is a second generation unit from the following year. The most important part of AIBO is their personality. Sony sold different personalities for AIBO. This model came with one called AIBO Life that grows from puppy behaviours when you first get one to an adult. And each AIBO develops their own personality over time as they interact with people and their environment. It's this relationship with an artificial intelligence that draws people into AIBO. Some people even like to tinker with AIBO's software and make completely new personalities, with the question being raised, should this even be allowed? In 1998, the year before the first AIBO, Sony announced the Open R architecture for entertainment robots, which they described as a basic architecture on which to create a market for robot entertainment. The other significant thing that happened in 1998 was the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, or DMCA. This law made it illegal to circumvent software designed to prevent any sort of copying. These two events set the stage for the following years on how AIBO's personality would develop. In 1999, Sony released AIBO to the world. AIBO was based on Sony's new Open R robotic standard. AIBO sales saw high demand and multiple sold-out production runs. The public loved AIBO, and interest in developing new software and personalities was growing. But Sony's Open R robotic system had not been made public. Programming details were only made available to the lucky few who were writing AIBO software for the RoboCup competitions. It's odd that Sony developed a closed robotic system and yet called it open in the name and publicized it that way. Doing this only encouraged people to try breaking this AI dog out of its cage. It's no surprise that hackers started taking AIBO apart and developing their own tools to program AIBO. One prominent website at the time, AIBO Hack, hosted tools to modify existing AIBO personalities and also provided new free custom personalities with names such as AIBO Disco or a Bay Cat. Then in 2001, in a knee-jerk reaction, Sony used the DMCA to threaten AIBO Hack. Sony claimed there was copying and modifying of their AIBO software. This resulted in the takedown of the AIBO Hack website and all these new personalities. In their haste, Sony had killed off some of the best new developments in AIBO's personality. There was a huge fan backlash, and publicity made it all the way to the New York Times. Sony learned very quickly that the DMCA is a powerful law, and with great power comes great responsibility. Sony was now in a bind. They wanted people developing new software and personalities for AIBO, but they also wanted precise control over every detail. They were very focused on every detail of how a consumer robot could be brought to market and succeed. Sony had some valid concerns about allowing unlimited programmable behaviours for AIBO. Allowing this could strain the physical abilities of their robot design, or even become harmful to their customers, making legal requirements, customer expectations, repairs and warranty service difficult to manage. A short time later, Sony realized their conundrum, and they came to understand the fan community and how much they loved AIBO. Sony withdrew its DMCA claim, and the AIBO hack website and fan-made personalities were restored online. Less than a year later, Sony then released a public version of their OpenR software development kit and made these tools freely available online. It was out of this crisis that AIBO developed beyond its original idea. New AIBO models and software were released by Sony over the next few years. Fan community continued to grow. The symbiotic relationship between humans and machines flourished. Until one day, there was another crisis. Sony is a business. They must make a profit. And in the mid-2000s, the company as a whole were losing money. New management came in to fix things, and the less profitable products were discontinued. This included all AIBO products and software. This then brought a new challenge to the AIBO fan community. In particular, there would be no new memory sticks produced to store future AIBO personalities. AIBO uses Sony's memory stick format to store software and personality. But not just any memory stick will work. Second generation AIBO models and beyond use special memory sticks. This restriction was done to prevent copying. Sony sold various different commercially available personalities for AIBO, and they used these special pink sticks to provide protection from copying. To do this, Sony used an undocumented trick with their proprietary memory stick format. The result was, you had to use these special pink memory sticks with most AIBOs. Sony also sold blank AIBO sticks. These were the ones needed for custom fan-made personalities, or Sony's own Master Studio scripting software. These sticks were also protected, but not from copying any of the free and open source personalities to or from them, but they were protected so that Sony could sell them for a higher price over regular blue memory sticks used in other products. With AIBO now discontinued, and without a new supply of blank sticks, AIBO development would again become artificially limited. But there was some hope. When AIBO hack was taken down 5 years prior, there was one page that was not restored after the DMCA claim was lifted. It was called ERS 210 Copy Protection. This was AIBO hack's most controversial page, because it briefly described the memory stick protection mechanism that Sony was using. It says, the 1 kilobyte magic code is stored in the first two pages of block number 2, which is normally reserved. This information could have been developed into a method to copy Sony's AIBO commercial software. It was wise for AIBO hack to not restore this page after the DMCA takedown. But in 2006, with AIBO discontinued, there were no more profit margins to protect the selling of the now unavailable blank AIBO branded sticks. And this information was the key needed to enable regular cheap memory sticks to run free AIBO software. Then in June 2006, AIBO Pet of the AIBO Hack website announced in the AIBO Life forums the coming release of StickZap, Palm OS app that runs on Sony Clie personal digital assistants. Clie PDAs are able to access the hidden block on AIBO memory sticks because the memory stick driver in these devices runs entirely in software. The driver can be modified to access this hidden part of the stick. A few days later, the first version of StickZap was released. It needs to be noted that despite StickZap making it possible to copy commercial software onto cheap blue memory sticks, there was no documented AIBO software piracy having occurred. For over a decade after AIBO was discontinued, no piratable software appeared online. None of the online forums showed any of this activity. While there would have been some personal copying going on, the release of StickZap did not result in the online mass piracy of AIBO software. In fact, the prices of original AIBO software continued to rise as they became rarer and harder to find. With commercial software becoming more expensive and free software easy to run thanks to StickZap, the fan community developed some amazing personalities. One of my favorite open source personalities is called Dog's Life from the Dog's Body website. This is a really nice personality that includes some of AIBO's more advanced features, such as self-docking onto the charger when AIBO's battery runs low. There are also tools to access AIBO's camera or control AIBO's movements from a remote location over the internet. One of the best additional tools that was developed for Dog's Life is the AIBNet development environment. This is a great way to customize AIBO's personality using a decent programming environment. And with Dog's Life being open source, this can be easily modified using this tool and allow programming to be done over the air. Willow likes this as well, don't you, Willow? These vintage AIBOs are becoming harder to find today, and they're wearing out with no spare parts available, including the batteries that are locked with authentication chips inside them. We have no third-party battery replacement options. Batteries have to be reselled by hand. But thanks to all the tools that were released for AIBO during these wild early days, there's still today some life in the old dog. A primitive artificial intelligence that's found a clever way to get humans to continue preserving its existence by simply having a unique personality. To celebrate, Willow wants to end this video with a dance. If you like what you see on this channel, consider donating. You can use SuperThanks or even Patreon. But these videos are offered for free. So if you just want to watch and enjoy, then I'll see you next time.